Good morning, ma. And sass. Good morning. Please, let's smile now. Good morning. Okay. My name is Ebenezer Dare. And today, we'll be doing a fantastic get together. Oh, it's not a get together. Okay, it's a training. Okay. Okay. Yeah, we'll be talking about real estate and the importance of digital marketing. In today's class, we want to talk about real estate and the importance of digital marketing. We've had several digital marketing classes. We've discussed a lot of things, but today's training is very unique and important. Please, I will need your audience, I will need your attention, and I want you to follow along with me. Okay? So we're looking at the real estate and the importance of digital marketing. With 84% of real estate professionals using social media platforms, how can realtors in the real estate industry further differentiate themselves in a saturated market? You see, what we've been doing before now is to tell realtors, to tell real estate professionals that move online. Your customers are waiting online. Go to social media. Make sure you have an online presence. Yeah, everybody is now online. Sometimes I have some contacts here in the some partners with Trumva here that when I'm checking my status sometimes, once in a while, I'll see somebody marketing, maybe Mr. Hay marketing Cloud Agard in Zibejuleki, is marketing Fair Evans in Ikorodu, is marketing Melegun, marketing Ikeja GRA. By the time I flip over to the next status, I'm seeing another person, another Trumva, what's it called? Trumva partner marketing the same Cloud Gardens, Ibejuleki, and marketing Ikeja GRA. So who should I buy from? If I have to be a customer, if I have to be a client now, which of you should I buy from? Because you guys are already giving me the headache of not knowing who to buy from. So many people are now online. So many people are now there. Everybody is now posting. There are several real estate companies. There are thousands of realtors now. Everybody is now posting their market online. The online platform is now saturated. So how can you now differentiate yourself? How can you now stand out? According to research, 84% of realtors are already online. Everybody is marketing their product. Everybody now knows the advantage of online. We were the one pushing that you guys should come online. Everybody should start marketing online. But now that everybody is now online, it has bring about another issue. There's another problem now that we now need to solve. So how do you as a realtor differentiate yourself, or how do you stand out in a saturated market? Okay, so your digital marketing strategy will now determine how you differentiate yourself, which means you don't just go online like everybody's going online now. There's something different, there's something unique that you must be doing or that you need to be doing. So let's talk about those strategies. The first of them here that I have today is you need to develop an email campaign. Develop an email campaign. Let me now ask this question at this stage. How many of you have sent out emails to your client before? You've actually sent out email. I can only see one hand up. Okay, making two now. Two. Maybe you've sent out emails before. You know why the number is very low? Because email marketing is difficult. It's not a rocket science. It's not as if it's not possible. But Nigerians are lazy to learn new things. We don't want to learn new tools. They don't want to learn new things. And when you see that many people are not there, that's why you should be there. Because you have many people at the bottom of the ladder. We only have few people at the top of the ladder. Email marketing works fantastic. Email marketing is awesome. But many people don't want to learn the tools to understand how email marketing works. We've spent a whole training day here before to train ourselves on how email marketing works. We've done email practical training on email marketing here before. But yet, we still have a limited number of people using email marketing because it's not straightforward. So if you cannot take your time to learn email marketing, please, I need you to send me that link. Oh, my phone is not here because somebody is requesting for the online link. Don't worry, I'll send. So let's go ahead. If you cannot train yourself on email marketing, you know how to send email marketing, you always get conversions, you always make sales. So how many of you are engaging in email marketing? How many of you want to take your time to even learn how email marketing works? Next slide. Okay, so email marketing is a valuable tool in connecting with new leads and staying relevant with past clients. Ideally, a well-rounded campaign will funnel potential clients through predetermined actions based on the buyer's need and previous engagement with you. It's not about you just hearing about email marketing. Now, many of us, what we do is after the training, after 2-3 hours after the training, you've forgotten about what we discussed. You need to go back home, sit down with your system, sit down with your phone, and understand how email marketing works. The last time we had a training here about email marketing, we used MailChimp to do a practical, You can use, there are several email platforms there that you can use. Gone are the days where you use your Yahoo Mail to send out email campaign to your clients. Why? Because by the time you are sending email to everybody, when you CC them, when you copy them, when you carbon copy them, all of them will see, everybody will see the other contact you are sending emails to, and you don't want to do that. By the time you say you want to do blind copy may not take more than maybe 50 people at a time, or there are certain number of people you can take at a time. But you want to send emails to tens of thousands of people, you want to send emails to hundreds of thousands of people at a go, and they will get it within 2-3 minutes, or in maximum 5 minutes. You use all these email companies, email campaign platforms. We have MailChimp, we have MailerLite, we have Aweba emails. There are several of them out there. But why we always push for MailChimp is because MailChimp has the free plan that you can send emails up to 2,000 people for free every month for life. As long as your contact is less than 2,000, you can be sending free emails. So you can sit down on MailChimp, understand the platform, how it works. It may take you 4 hours. It may take you 3 hours. It may take you 5 hours. Make sure you understand how that platform works. Make sure that you learn it and you are sending out emails, because not many reactors are sending out emails. You see everybody on WhatsApp status, you see everybody on Facebook, you see everybody on Instagram, everybody is there. By the time I see your advert, by the time I see his advert and I see your own advert, then you put me in a confusion state. Who should I go with? Who should I even buy from now? I'm even confused. So the best thing I would do is to keep my money first. And you are not making sales and you are losing. So you now need to look for another channel to reach me. So that most people check their emails. Most people are always, as long as you have a smartphone, you have an email, you can't literally do many things on your phone without an email, as long as you're using a smartphone. Yes, ma'am. So according to an online research, an average open rate of emails for real estate businesses is around 27%, with a click-through rate of at least 3%. That percentage is still low. But even despite that low percentage, how many people are even sending emails? Which means every time you even send email, the percentage of, if you are sending emails to, let's say, 2,000 people now, is only 3% of them that will even click. They will open it too. 27% of them will open it. Out of those 27% that will open it, they will read the content. Only 3% will click to move to the next level. Simply because those 3%, maybe your content is attractive to them. That's why they will click on it. That's the more reason why you now need to get more percentage, more database, more people you are sending out emails to in a month, so that you know that all these people I'm sending out to, at least 27% of them will open my emails. They will see it, and at least 3% of them will click it. From those 3%, if you can convert 1% of them, you make sales. However, the more relevant your content is to a client, the more likely they'll be interested in opening the email to see what you have to say. So make sure you are churning out emails. Make sure you are sending out emails minimum once in a week. If you can do twice a week, fantastic. Get designs, banners. The advantage of those email templates is because you can combine pictures and words. You can use images and text. You can even put video on your email. People tend to relate more with videos, they tend to relate more with images just than normal, ordinary text. When you use Yahoo to send out emails or you use Gmail, you don't have the opportunity of attaching those images unless you want to do an attachment. And people, let me tell you, they're scared of opening an attachment today because of all these our Yahoo boys that they will send virus to an attachment. So, but when they open the email and they see the image, have you seen those images before that when you open your email, you just see a banner first? The banner is attractive enough to call to your attention and you want to go through the test. Sometimes there's a link there and you click on those links. Those people are actually using all these email templates, all these email platforms to send out the emails. So I think you should start doing that now. the market is already saturated. Everywhere is saturated. So it's time for you to start doing things that are difficult, that people presume difficult, that some people don't want to do, for you to stand out. Mr. John is in Zanzibar. I want to go to Dubai. So I need to stand out. Yes. Yeah, I need to stand out. Next slide. So the next thing to do, the next thing, number two, is you need to create a user-friendly website. I was personally, I've said it in trainings before in this place, that you don't need a website now. Yes, I said so. But it's time for you to now, let's say if you've made a sales and you get a commission of 150K, 200,000, it's time for you to budget like 50K, between 30 to 50,000 to build a user-friendly website. It's time for you to have a website so that when you send out email, you are putting the link of your website to that email, that when people are clicking, because even when you send out emails now and you want to put a link, where do you want to direct them to? By the time you direct them to the company's website, they will buy directly from the company. You've lost the sales. Now, sending out email is important, but you sending out email, where do you want to direct the people to? Because they need to click a link on your email. There should be a button. All those sample, by the time you go through Mailchimp, you see that all those templates, most of them, they will always have buttons, they will always have images, they will always have all those dummy something, that all you need to do is just to change the text, change the button link, change all those things. So by the time you want to put your own link, where do you want to direct them to? So if you've been making sales already, if you've made one or two sales, it's high time for you to have a minimum, at least a simple, user-friendly website. It's time for you to say, okay, let me budget 30K. Though some people might not want to do those kind of small websites, but you have young developers that are just coming up, that at least when they see a 30K project now, to them, is a big project because they are just coming up. So you can engage these guys. You can even get your hosting and your own domain name by yourself and just look for somebody that, okay, I have my tools already, just help me build my website, and you give the person 10,000. And the person will just help you put, and he will do it for you. Find a website. So, but what are the things that you should have on those on your user-friendly website? Very important. Your website must be mobile-friendly, because many people will always access your website from their phone. When they are checking your emails and you send them an email campaign, 60% of them will read it from their phone. Only 30% will do from their laptop or their desktop. But majority of them, so quarter of them will do it from their phone. So make sure that your website is mobile-friendly. When I mean mobile-friendly, means they can navigate through everything on their phones. Not that one side will be hiding and they say, if you check it on laptop, it's fine. But it's not fine on the phone. What's the essence? So it must be mobile-friendly. It must contain a list of all your properties. Your website must contain a list of all your properties. So you can talk to a graphic design person to help you design the banner for all the properties you are marketing. Especially if you are doing that, you are marketing for multiple real estate companies. If you have all those products, you have your own banner designed for you, then you must have content that will guide the potential client through the buying process. The content must be able to convince and not confuse your potential client that it is high time you need to get a property. So you must come up with relevant content. Links to relevant related services like legal, like government, all those. Maybe there's the particular property in a particular location. There's a government declaration on it, or government, whatever they call it. And on the government agency website, they have the procedures or the process on their website. You can just copy the link and add it to your own website so that people can click on those links and go through to read all those procedures on that land. This land has this land has that. Yes, you can say it with mouth. Yes, you can just put it on your website. But when people click on a link to a relevant source, it gives them confidence. Maybe when the link is directing them to Lagos State, maybe you are selling the properties at Ikorodu, and the link is directing them to the Lagos State Agency, and they are seeing .lasg.gov.ng. They know that it's directly from the government. So they will be calm. They will have the confidence in you and in your property. Also, if there are some lawyers, there are several real estate legal firms that put out content about documentation about properties too. You can just direct them to those kind of links. You can be on your website. So 24/7 live chat, they must be able to reach you instantly. They must be able to reach you on the fly. I said preferably WhatsApp plugin. You can have a WhatsApp plugin on your website that when you just click on that WhatsApp button. It will direct them to your phone. I have it on my website. We have it on Trumbi website, that when they just click on the WhatsApp login, it will direct them to the most important person's number, and that maybe the business unit, the customer, the business development manager, or the customer support that can give them information that they need. So you must have live chat. Your contact must be there. They must be able to, if they want to reach out to you via email or via phone number, they must be able to call you on the instant and get through to you. And also any other or many other important details that you think should be on the website. You can go through other real estate companies' website and see the kind of information they have on their website. But the bottom line here is that it's high time for you to have at least a simple, user-friendly website. And when you have a website too, it does not just, it helps in so many areas, so many things. It gives your potential clients the confidence that they are dealing, they are doing business or they want to do business with somebody that is well-structured. They are doing business with not just an individual, but an organization. Thank you, sir, for that word. A formidable person, somebody that is formidable, somebody they can rely on, somebody they can trust, somebody that they can deal with. People don't want to take risk nowadays. It's even riskier to take risk. So they don't want to take risk with their money. They don't want to take risk with 11 million Ibeju-Lekki property. At the end of the day, they will not see you, they will not see their money. But when you have a website, they know that they can always track you. They know that they can always get you. And even another advantage of you having a website is that people that are searching online randomly can come across your product. They can come across your website while you are sleeping. The guys in diaspora, they are in the daytime, and they are surfing online. They don't trust their brothers again. They don't trust their family members again because they've swindled their money, and they want to buy directly themselves, and they're searching for a good company they can buy from. Yeah, they won't go to Facebook to search for you. They won't go to Instagram to search for you. They will go to Google. They will go online. They will go to all the search engines. They will search, and they see your website. They want to reach out to you. They want to contact you. So this search engine optimization will rank your website as long as you have an online presence, you have a website. Next slide. The third thing to do now is what we call pay-per-click. Pay-per-click advertising. It's high time for you to start putting money in adverts. Not the normal free platform. When you post on your Facebook, it's only the people that are your friends there that will see it. When you post on your Instagram, it's only people that are following that will see it. When you post on your status, it's only people that have your contact and that you also have their contact, that you both save your contact, that will see it. But with pay-per-click adverts, means your advert will be there online. Many people will see it. You only pay when people click on the advert. They will only charge you when somebody click on your advert. So if somebody did not click on your advert, they are not going to charge you. They will only charge you when somebody click on your advert. You can see when you have all these kind of people are searching on Google and they come across, let's say, your website and you've already advertised, you are running a Google AdWord on your website, you are doing pay-per-click. So until somebody click on your website link from Google, that's when Google will charge you. The challenge about this thing is that it's not something you learn in one training. The challenge about it is that it's not something you learn once and go. You need to do your own research. You need to sit down on it personally, or you need to engage a digital marketing firm that can train you on how these things are being done. But the foundation is for you to know what to do or what you want to do. Once you know what you want to do, your problem is half solved. The next thing is now for you to now get how to do it. So you can engage pay-per-click adverts on Google AdWords. There are several free online courses. There are several free content online that you can use to get all these things that have been done. And if it's proving difficult, you can go for a digital marketing training. Let them train you specifically on how you get these things done. There are several digital marketing schools. I don't run digital marketing school. I don't even do digital marketing adverts for people because there's a lot of things to do. But there are several digital marketing schools outside there that you can engage. Okay, I want to learn this particular tool. I want to learn how these things are being done. If you are serious, if you are interested in making sales, if you are interested in making online sales, making sales, when you are sleeping, your money will be working for you, then you need to engage all these tools that we've been talking about today. There are not much. I'm just going to be giving you four of them. I've already talked about three. Next slide. So pay-per-click is also known as PPC advertising. Is an excellent strategy for realtors looking to generate new leads based on ads that you pay for every time your ads get clicked. The keyword is until they click on your advert, you are not paying. So PPC is a great digital marketing option for real estate professionals seeking potential clients who may genuinely be interested in your offering, as you only pay when someone clicks through your ad. Often, PPC ads can be targeted towards individuals who have searched for correlated keywords in Google or in other search engines, which means by the time you are churning out content, maybe you are writing blogs or you're on your website, you've put all this real estate properties, all these keywords, you already embed them in your website. Because when you are doing a website for your real estate business, at least real estate must be appearing on your website. Properties must be appearing. So when people are searching for those correlated keywords, your website will jump up. And when you now do pay-per-click, your website will come to the top. Anytime you go to Google to go and search, you always notice that the first two or three websites you see AD beside them. They are adverts. Before Google will show organic websites, before they will give you the website of people that are not paying, they will first of all push people that have paid them. They'll push the website. So when you see the content you are looking for at the top already, why do you want to scroll down? Or why do you want to go to the next page? Maybe when you are not doing pay-per-click, your adverts or your website will be appearing on the next, on the second page or on the third page. Because other people are also pushing their own website. So but when you do pay-per-click, your website will be at the top. So people can easily click on your website and they get all the information they need, they contact you, and they are buying from you. And the fourth strategy, there are more, but I've just decided because of time to just limit them to at least four, so that by the time you go home with these four, and you can work on these four fantastic, and you can do a good job on these four strategies, then the other ones are just on the side. Create and post valuable content. Create and post value. Talk to people about real estate. Talk to people. Give out free content. Come up with content. We are at Ibejulekki on Saturday. We went to see for allocation and inspection. We went to see the place. And you can see people bringing out their phones to do video, to talk about how the property. This property is just almost opposite MN Estate Phase 1. When people hear that one, MN Estate Phase 1, the next thing is I'm interested. I'll be seeing Funke Akindele every day. I am interested. I want to also act in the Omoghetto saga. So people want to relate with, they want their neighbors to be high caliber people. They know that MN Estate is not cheap. As far back as 8 years ago, a building in MN Estate was going for 120 million. Imagine how much you'll be selling now. So which means the people that are living there, they are not low level people. So and when you now have a neighbor, when you now have an estate that is directly opposite to MN Estate, people want to come and invest in the property. Even the property is not sharing fence with the phase two, MN Estate phase two. So people are interested. That's why you see people bringing out phones. So you need to keep churning out content. You need to keep telling people about your properties. You need to keep telling people why they should go for properties, why they should invest now. They must see you as a master in your field. They must see you, right? When they are thinking about real estate properties, your name or your picture, your face must always come up. So you need to give out content. Even you yourself, when you need some information about real estate, you go online to go and search. The ones you are searching for online, is it not people that are putting them online? Some people are showing, they are putting the content so that you can get, so you to put out content. When you put out content, you rank high. People will get to know you. People will get to call you. People will get to buy from you. A blog is a fantastic way to level up your SEO. Build a positive reputation online and provide your clients with actionable advice on buying a home or a piece of your property. A real estate professional's digital marketing strategy is nothing without valuable content, whether it's shared on your website or on your social media platforms. You must keep churning out content. You must keep telling people about it. Maybe you can just pick a particular location today and tell them about the location. Tell them why they should invest in the location. Tell them the advantage of investing in properties. Tell them the advantage of investing in real estate. That you are going to website and using website and using email campaign does not mean you should stop what you are doing on your social media platform. They are still relevant, they are still important. But because we have more people there now, let's move up a little bit. let's get to the top of the ladder where people don't literally want to go to because it's difficult climbing. So you now pushing via all these other means of strategizing, of marketing, to bring sales for your real estate business. Next slide. So because content is such a valuable asset to good SEO strategy, make sure that you update your blog regularly. SEO that I'm saying here, I'm repeating here, means search engine optimization. When people are searching, when they are searching, your content can be ranking online. Let me tell you one fantastic advantage of using the social media platform. When you have good content and you are posting, when people are searching, Facebook, maybe there's a post on Facebook, your Facebook can rank your post. Your post can come up on Google search. It will be under Facebook. It will show that it's Facebook, but yes, it's your post. So when people click it, they will read about your post. LinkedIn, when you post on LinkedIn and people are searching for related keywords, your post on LinkedIn can come up. Though it's on LinkedIn, it's not from your website, it's on LinkedIn, but yet people get to see it and they can relate with you and they can contact you as long as you leave your contact on the blog post. So those social media platforms are still very important. So when you are churning out your content, when you are writing your articles, you post everywhere. You post on all the social media platforms. You also post on your website so that it can rank everywhere. So by the time you are posting, your SEO will not help your post to come up. By the time you are always updating regularly, you should at least write article once in a week about your business. If this is what you are doing, if you are a realtor and this is what you are doing, somebody has said something before. He said, if I'm doing this thing full time, somebody that is doing it part time should not be doing better than I do. Somebody that is doing it part time should not be making sales more than you that you are doing full time. Let me tell you the truth. The guy we are celebrating this week now that traveled, that the company paid his all expense trip to Zanzibar, he's working somewhere else. Yes, he made millions of sales within the first quarter of the year that the company had to send him out on a free 1 week vacation. If you that you are not doing this full time, you are not getting that trip, means there's many things you are not doing, not just something. So you should be churning out articles minimum once on a weekly basis. It's tiring. It can be tiring. It can be stressful for you to come up with good article. But if you are not lazy, you can always come up with article. It's not sweet when you are writing content. You may, especially if you are the type that loves procrastinating, you may not be able to achieve one article in a month. But if you can give yourself, if you can be disciplined enough to task yourself that at least I must have one article a week about real estate, put your keywords separate, put everything you want to talk about today. You want to talk about why people should get a land. Tomorrow you want to talk about a particular property somewhere. Next tomorrow you want to talk about what's even digits of assignment. Many people don't know the meaning of digits of assignment. Many people don't know the meaning of C of O. When they see C of O, somebody will still be asking, is C of O and certificate of occupancy, is it the same thing? So you want to tell them, yes, they don't know. They don't know. They've been working oil and gas all their life. They just have the money saved in their account. Bank is just using their money to do forest. They need to keep that money. They need to use that money to invest in property. And you also need to take your commission so that you can build a fantastic website and make more sales. So, but you need to tell them. So you need to be putting up articles at least once in a week. And there are several platforms that apart from Facebook, LinkedIn, that you can still post your articles, like all these bloggers that allow you to post your articles for free, like Negaland, like Negametrics. There are several platforms there that they are bloggers, but they still allow you to do guest posts that you post, and they will put it. They will approve it. It will go. And more people will see your content. So once you have the content, it's now left for you to now go every platform to go and share and distribute your post. So if you have not been writing content, I mentioned Negametrics too, and there are several of them online that you can search out. So, and you can always do, you just take your phone out once in a while, do live video, talk to people about real estate, prepare your content already. You've already prepared what you want to talk about, and do live video, talk to people about it. You can even do this, this is a bonus. You can even bring, let's say you bring one of these real estate professionals that people know already, do a live Facebook live stream. Just say, okay, sir, just do a banner, do a Facebook live stream. Let people just connect online. After, once you are through with the live stream, maybe because you are not known yet or because you don't have much followers on your account, maybe let's say less than 10, 20 people join the live stream. Download the video, re-upload on your Instagram, and let people be seeing it. Share it on all your status. Share it on all your social media. I did a live the other time that I'm seeing on Facebook now. How do you do it? You can download this. So you can always download, do a live stream. Invite Mr. Adeni Adeyemi. Do a live stream with him. When people see his face and they are the number one bishop of real estate in Africa, they want to connect, they want to join. And for the people that couldn't join at the time when the live stream was going on, download and re-upload on Instagram, re-upload on Facebook, re-upload on LinkedIn. Make sure you are using all this platform. You can even push on your TikTok. I know many of us are not on this platform, but because of your business, please join. Because of your business, please be on all these social media platforms so that people can get to know you, people can get to see you, people can get to buy from you. Typically, the material that is ranked highest on Google is between 1,000 to 1,004 words and 1,285 words. So it may be a good idea to write high-value, long-form content on a regular basis. There are some kind of your content, when you write 500 words, it may not rank. So it should be between these words, 1,140 words and 1,285 words. By the time you write A and you put space, that's a word. By the time you write with and you put space, that's a word. Make sure it's between all those words you are writing. And by the time you write two words together, put hyphen in between, is one word. So make sure that your words are between these numbers that we've mentioned, 1,140 and 1,285, so that Google can also help you in doing free adverts by ranking your articles, by ranking your blog post. Next slide. So in conclusion, this is an advice, and I've mentioned it already in this training. In conclusion, invest in digital marketing training if you need to. If you are not the one that can learn on your own, if there's what we call DYOR, DYOR, do your own research. If you are not the type that can do your own research, you always want people to guide you. You always want somebody to tell you what to do. You always want somebody to teach you before you can learn or before you can grab. Then invest in digital marketing training. In the modern marketplace, digital marketing skills are becoming ever more important in running a successful real estate business. By choosing to invest in digital marketing training, you can ensure that you have the skill set necessary to stand out from your competition. Another advantage that this will give to you is that you won't just be doing it for yourself. You can also be doing digital marketing adverts for other real estate companies, for your other competitors, and you'll be making more money from there. So once you can even understand how to use digital marketing for yourself, it can make you more money. So I think that's the last slide. Hello, man. Next slide. So that's the end of our training for today. We've been able to do 30 minutes. Questions?
There's a question. Okay. Please, what sometimes always have good views? There are some time.
For blog post, if for article, when you say post, let me know what you mean now.
Post is, like, even Instagram, Facebook, people's status.
If you want to post image, if you want to post on status, you know that you don't want to post between 8 and 5 p.m., 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. because people will be busy. So you are posting either early or you are posting late in the evening, anytime from that 4 or 5 downward, that people will be going home, they're inside traffic, they need something to keep them busy when you're posting the image. So, or you can as well post in the daytime, maybe on a weekend, so that people can see your post. But when you're posting an article, I can tell you that you can always post it any time of the day, anytime, because it's not compulsory that people will see it immediately you post it. Another person can come and see your article 2 years later, 3 years later, and they'll still buy from you. The most important thing is for you to have an online presence. The most important thing for you is to be relevant online. Make sure you are churning out content that people can relate to. So somebody can see your post 2 years later, 1 week later, 2 months later. So you can post at any time. You can post at any time. The only reason why we always advise when you're posting images or videos is maybe you need people that you want to get attention almost immediately. You want them to see the post before they get to work and they are busy with their day's activity, or you want them to see it when they are in traffic, so that they can easily relate with it. That works more for traditional marketing. When you have all these billboards, they want the advert to run when there's traffic. But for you that you are doing online, you can post anytime. Even some people will be busy, you think they are working, they are busy surfing Facebook, and your advert and your post will be going through. So you can always post at any time. Any other question?
Yes,
Okay, sir. I don't know anything about that, but what I've mentioned is that I was talking about websites, that if you have a website, make sure you have a WhatsApp login on your website, that when people are visiting your website, they can click on the plugin and they can reach you on your phone. When there's a WhatsApp login on your website, if you go to Stromvire website, for example, now, if you check on Stromvire website, you will see there's always a WhatsApp plugin there. When you click on that plugin, a very important person in the organization will be seeing your chat. So you can ask your question and you can guarantee to get answer almost immediately. So for on your website, you can have a WhatsApp plugin. You can just tell your developer, anybody that is building your website, they will know how to do that for you. Put a plugin there so that people can reach you on WhatsApp. The reason why we even advise WhatsApp plugin here in this part of the world is because we have more people on WhatsApp than any other plugin. There are other means, there's all this talk to live chat that people can pull up, but those live chat, unless you log into the back end of your application before you can see people that have chatted you. So, and at that time, it may not be almost immediate again. That person has already made his decision. He has already gone somewhere else because you are not responding on time. But with the WhatsApp plugin, you're on your bed and you hear the alert come that somebody's trying to chat you, you see the message, you can easily respond on the fly. So for your website, that's the one, but I wouldn't know the one that he told or talked about or told you about.
Actually,
so you guys can talk about that later.
For those of us that are here to have website, I think he taught us creating a page on Facebook. You know, that would be a kind of avenue for people to know what you are doing with your Facebook page.
Yes. Adrian that talked about that. It could be the content guy. It could be George.
Yeah,
it could be George. Yeah. It's when you are running, when you want to run an advert on your Facebook, that can only work when you want to run an advert. So instead of when you don't have your website, instead of directing people to your website, you can direct them to your WhatsApp number. When you are trying to do a Facebook advert, yes, that can work. That can work on the Facebook page. Yes, you can put your WhatsApp numbers too on the Facebook page so that people can click on the WhatsApp link on your Facebook page and they will still reach you. But that's limited to Facebook. So we're talking about a more expansive one now that can your website and everything. So yes, it's that. So he can take your guys on that. And if time permits, I can always also take you on that. So that's that for that. Okay, sir. The first thing is content, keywords. When you are writing a blog post, one thing, if you want to write a blog post, what we always advise is that you list some keywords that you want to mention. You want to mention all these keywords, all these properties, real estate, blah, blah, blah. You list them. You now build your content around those keywords. You now be building your content. You must make sure that all these keywords that you've listed is appearing on your content. So you now build your write up around those content, make sure that they are appearing. Even if you don't want to talk about a particular thing, but because you need that keyword to appear, so you just want to talk about it. And one thing I will tell you about blog posts again is that if you've written a blog post, let's say 2-3 months ago, you can go back and update it and just flesh it up, add one or two lines, or just change one or two things so that I can start ranking up again. Because when you've written it for a while, it might have gone down. But by the time you now jig it, you just update it with, let's say, a new paragraph. Just add something new. Search engine will see it as a, and you submit it again. Search engine will see it as a new content, as a fresh content, and it will start ranking again. When you submit it to where you want to submit it now, okay. Your platforms, your Facebook, you are submitting it to LinkedIn, you are submitting it on your website. When you are posting, that's what I mean by submitting.
Okay.
When you are posting, when you are clicking on post, when you are clicking on publish, you are submitting. So which means they will see it as a fresh content and they will rank it again. So instead of you always trying to build new content from scratch every time, you can always just update those old content and rejig it and refresh and freshen it up and it look like a new content. Yes, sir? I'm coming, sir, I'm coming. Yes, sir. If you know you cannot undo it yourself, please outsource it. As long as the person is, as long as the person has the integrity, the person is doing your job, as long as the person is delivering, then you can. If you know that you don't have the time, or if you know that you don't have the expertise, you can always outsource your digital marketing.
Sometimes it's just like some websites, they have not been in the system for long. When you check it out, Google, apart from Google, they come up with the first thing you find.
Yes, they are doing pay-per-click, they are doing adverts, they are always running adverts.
Okay.
They are always doing their search engine optimization, even if they are not updating their website. But they're always running ads so that people can see them.
My question is in two forms. Okay, number one, can one use Google Insights as a website? And if one is using it, can articles be, I mean, more, we don't just want articles, several articles be added to it that we can see if it's a real website. That one is one. Two, can one use Google Blogspot to be able to ensure that can one use paid paid blog or free blog like WordPress and Blogspot?
Sir, that second question, I would have leave it to your developer to answer it, but let me just answer it on the fly. It's better for you to, because the question is not that clear like that. WordPress is not a free blog. Even though they have free templates, even though they have a free theme, it's not free. So don't see WordPress as a free blog. It's not free. It's a paid whatever. So it's always advisable to go for, if you are building a website, to use a premium themes that will get your job done, because you may not be able to update those free blogs. And if you are using Google Blogspot, it's not advisable because it's not still your, because you are advertising for Google, you are not the sales, it may not still give you the kind of relevancy that you want. So you can always go for, so that's how you should get a developer to help you get your website, at least, no matter how simple, no matter how small, just start from somewhere. Your first question again. Google Insights. Google Insights is not a website. Google Insights is a tool. It's just one of the tools. Like, you have Google Planner, you have Keywords Planner, you have Google AdWords, you have Google AdMob. Google has several tools. They have several services that they are using. So Google Insights is just a tool that you can use to determine how to write your article or to help your SEO strategy. So it's not a website. So it's just one of the tools you use online to get your job done. I think that will be all for now. Or is there any last question before we go? That'll be all for now. Thank you very much for your time, and thank you for everything. God bless you.